Come in, Consuelo. Is Mr. Cromwell up?
I don't know.
Ma'am.
Ma'am.
How many times do I have to tell you? I always want to know what my brother is doing, especially when he is in this house. That is one of your jobs. Consuelo?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you check yourself in the mirror every morning like I told you?
Yes.
Well, you don't do it very well. Check again. Where'd you get that dress?
You gave it to me.
Well, take it off.
Pardon me?
The dress. I can't very well mend it with you in it now, can I? Well, come on, I haven't got all day. And bring my coffee over before it gets cold.
Ma'am? Miss Parnell?
Consuelo, my ear is closer to this sewing machine than it is to your mouth.
When can I go?
Go. Go where?
Go out.
Consuelo, we have a backyard as big as Central Park.
No, no, I don't mean that.
Then what do you mean?
I mean out, into the street, the city, the river, places.
How many times do I have to remind you?
I know, I know. I'm illegal.
Yes, you are illegal, an illegal alien. If you want to go out, fine. But don't expect me to bail you out when you are picked up and deported.
I'd be careful.
You have food in your stomach, right? Clothes on your back, a roof over your head, and who gives you all this, hmm? Who? I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
You.
Who?
You, ma'am.
Yes. Me, ma'am. But you, you and your selfish desire to go out, you don't give a damn what happens to me, do you? Your selfishness could land me in jail. That's the thanks I get.
I haven't been to mass. Confession.
Oh, you have something to confess, Consuelo. Something I should know about?
What if I get sick?
A very good point, especially as at this time of year, Sacramento is full of allergies. A very good reason for you to stay in the house.
But, ma'am...
Try this on. Turn around. You know, Consuelo, some people never know when they're well off.
Mr. Tess?
Thanks.
I've never been offered huevos rancheros.
You ever asked?
For breakfast?
It's a breakfast food. What?
When there's a right way and a wrong way of doing things, why do you always choose the latter?
Meaning?
Meaning God gave us two hands, one to hold a fork and one to hold a knife.
You know why the Puritans fled England?
You're the history major.
Intolerance.
What's that got to do with using a knife?
Oh, well... Having decided to leave the sceptered isle, it was going to be a long journey. So there's plenty of time to set up a new lifestyle, to rid themselves once and for all from establishment England and all of its constraints and its social semaphores and conformity. So there were a lot of proposals, lots of votes. Wigs and powder for men? No. Dandy clothes for the rich? Rags for the poor? No. One dress, one social order. Allegiance to a king or a potentate? No. All equal in the eyes of God and each other. You ever wonder where fast food restaurants come from?
Something tells me I'm about to find out.
It was a Thursday. They were just over halfway across. And all of a sudden, this little guy gets up and he says, "Knives and forks are for the bourgeois! Let's get rid of them!" So everyone around this great cheer goes up and he says, "No more knives and forks! No more knives and forks!" But then this little lady gets up, right? And, well, you know how practical women are, right? She says, "What if we don't use knives and forks? What will we use?" So the little guy looks at her and he goes, "Fingers!" And that's where the fast food restaurants come in, right? So then the lady, she says, "Well, yes, but surely we're not animals." So of course everyone looks around at one another and yes, they have to agree with that. And then this elder stands up and he says, "We will always be British. And the hallmark of Britain is compromise. We will discard one or the other, but not both." So guess which way the vote went. And it doubles as a toothpick.
But you're no Puritan in any way, shape, or form. Consuelo, don't do that.
They're washing up?
That uses too much power. It's too expensive. Besides, what if we have a blackout? Well, what if? Are we supposed to eat off the floor until the power comes back on and then we can have clean dishes? So why don't we get a jump on the utility company, And rinse them properly. I don't want to see detergent streaks all over my clean plates. Typical.
Why are you so hard on her?
What's it to you? Or do you include her in your disenfranchise? Those useless bums you serve down at the mission?
Not everybody's as privileged as we are.
Privileged? If you think looking after you and her and this house and everything else is a privilege, then you're a bigger jerk than I give you credit for. And you don't have to devote your life to the lowest of the low.
I like to feel like I'm doing something useful.
Useful? Useful? You want to do something useful? Repair the radiator in my bathroom. You still haven't fixed it.
I told you it needs a plumber.
When are you going to stop dreaming, Dad? When are you going to get a real job? Consuelo, don't forget to plug in the heater when you run my bath. Warm the room.
Why do you always bathe mid-morning?
I allow myself few luxuries. One is a leisurely bath. And mid-morning means you're gone, she's cleaning, and I'm free of both of you for 30 precious minutes.
Well, here's one less for you to worry about.
Don't forget the heater. Do my bedroom now, and don't forget to turn the mattress.
Welcome. Thanks
a lot.
You're welcome. Hey, Charlie, how's it going?
Hanging in there.
You still off the stuff?
Cleaned for a couple months.
It's not easy though, huh?
How would you know?
Charlie, we're all on your side.
Sure. But who fights the battle?
Charlie still clean?
Yeah. With no hope of ever getting a foot on the ladder of acceptability, how long's it gonna last?
I've told you before, Deb, you can't get too close, too caught up with these people.
And how do you do that, Jack? You come here every single day. How do you not be affected by them, by their plight?
You ever thought of doing a real job?
Jesus, Jack. I'm sorry. You just sound like my sister. Yeah.
She doesn't approve of your work here?
Very little of what I do meets with Parnell's approval.
That's a strange name. Parnell?
Yeah, she's named after Charles Stuart Parnell. He's a great Irish freedom fighter. I'm named after Eamon de Valera, known to all and sundry as Dev, the father of modern Ireland. But you're right. Parnell is a very strange name for a very strange girl.
You know, when you first came to us, you justified it by claiming privilege carries responsibility, a sort of egalitarian noblesse oblige. A master's degree in history. That's a privilege if ever I saw one.
Meaning?
Teach.
Teach.
You have a way with people. They respond to you. And with your academic qualifications?
I don't have a teacher's certificate.
So?
So I'd have to go back to school to get one.
So what's the problem?
Parnell is the problem.
Your sister?
My estate is held in trust. See, Parnell and I have the same father. We have two different mothers. My parents' will directed that if they died together, which they did, Parnell would become executor of the estate. She's got me on this rigid, fixed monthly allowance that is in no way enough for teachers training college.
That's a cop-out.
Mm-mm. No, Jack, that's my sister.
Whatever happened to her mother?
Parnell's mother was dead set on having a boy. Parnell arrived on the scene, she just couldn't handle it. Up and left, and nobody ever saw or heard from her again. How come you never light that thing?
I don't smoke.
Am I supposed to do all the washing up on my own?
Your turn
to dry.
You always were the favored one.
Well, all she did was give me an extra helping of broccolini.
Did she give me an extra helping of broccolini?
Parnell, is that important to you?
It is to me.
As important as me getting a real job?
As important as it is for you to use a fork and a knife.
Mm. That important?
You mentioned a job?
Teaching.
Teaching?
Mm-hmm. Well, I have a master's degree in history. I've been told I'm good with people. I think I'd be good at it.
Oh, I think I hear the aspirations of a failed Jack Lyons trying to boom vicariously through you.
Failed? He's a reverend, for Christ's sake.
Hardly the CEO of a Fortune 500 company. And would you need a teaching diploma?
Of course.
And how do you propose obtaining it?
At teacher's training college. How else?
And paid for. How? Well, after all, Dev, you're not exactly adept at handling money. When have you ever paid a bill? Who looks after your truck? Handles the insurance? Stands in line at the DMV? You? You don't even have a checking account. You long ago abdicated all responsibility for money, and you're 28 years old. So I repeat, paid for. How?
You adjust my allowance. It's that simple.
Dev, nothing in life is simple. Added to which, I don't happen to share Jack Lyons' enthusiasm for your ability to teach.
What's that mean?
It means no. N-O. Do what normal people do. Get a job and put yourself through school.
That inheritance is mine. It's my money.
Which is invested in various stocks and bonds, which generate interest, which maintain the principal, which ensure that you receive an allowance.
I want it.
You work for it!
What if I wanted to get married? Need money for that.
Oh, so now you want to leave me to fend for myself.
I didn't say
typical.
That.
Typical.
Mm-mm. It's not what I said.
Thinking only of yourself, Dev, and damn the rest of us, right?
Now I know why your mother abandoned you. I pity you.
I don't need your pity. I need Consuelo to bring this to my room. Dev, now, before it gets cold.
Your sister, she is difficult, no?
My sister is difficult. Yes.
What is my brother doing?
I think he's in his place.
His den?
Yes, ma'am.
How often do you vacuum in there?
Oh, Mr. Dev, he says not to bother.
Not to bother? Not to bother? We'll see about that. Dev? Dev? I know you're in there.
Change your mind?
When was this room last?
It's my little refuge. No college, no entry.
I have no need to come in. She does.
Sorry, Deb.
Give me the vacuum. I'm perfectly capable of cleaning my own room.
It's not about ability, Deb. It's about responsibility. Clean it, top to bottom.
What if I say no?
What if I withhold your allowance, period? I have that power.
These are yours? All yours? Not your children's?
Consuelo, I'm not married, remember?
Not ever?
Not ever. It's my father, his business partner.
Bruce Hudson, Willis Hawk. I never hear of these actors.
Not many people have.
You make things.
Make, modify, rebuild. Even if I can't fix a radiator. It's a telephone.
Yeah. Are they valuable?
Some, more than others. This one is my favorite. It's also the oldest and the most valuable.
Finished the vacuuming?
I was just showing her my collection.
His favorite.
Sweet. But you're here to work. Do it.
Miss Parnell? Miss Parnell, are you there?
¿Por qué tanto tiempo desde tu última confesión?
Soy una prisionera.
En un modo u otro todos somos prisioneros. En una circunstancia de conciencia.
Por medios. ¿Cuál eres tú?
Ya le dije, padre. Una presa.
Esta es la primera vez que salgo en cualquier parte en meses.
¿Estás diciendo que te tienen encerrada?
Soy ilegal. No tengo papeles.
Mitad de los que viven en California son
ilegales. Yo no puedo salir. No me atrevo. Ella dice que seré detenida y seré deportada.
¿Quién es ella?
Padre, por favor, escucha mi confesión.
No, señor, por favor. No tienes nada que temer.
Señora, señora, por favor. Por favor, señora. Está en tus manos, ya.
Stop! Stop! Hey, stop! Stop!
No!
Stop! No! 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 Hey, no, Consuela! It's me, Deb! It's me! It's me! Consuela! Consuela! It's Deb! It's me, Deb! It's Deb! It's Deb! It's me, Deb! It's Deb! It's Deb! What the hell's going on?
Please take me home.
Door slammed shut. Where's your key?
Where's your seatbelt?
I don't like being tied down. Where's your key? Suit yourself.
Save many souls today? Such as Consuelo's. I saw her get out of your truck. What's up with you two? You fucking her?
No. Are you? Female, wolf, fox, or dog. Five letters.
Consuelo! Consuelo! Do that last. Did you do the card room? Spotless. Then go do the sandwiches exactly like I showed you. You're too late.
For what?
Breakfast. Consuelo has more important things to do.
Such as?
Prepare for my guests.
Right. It's that time of month, isn't it? Cards at Parnell's. What was it Joe Gillis called them? Her waxworks.
Do us both a favor, huh? Lie low.
I'll lock myself in my den. My clean den.
Have a good one. Deb! It'll start better with these. What would you do without me? Jesus God, you dago ditz, you bumbling idiot! Don't you listen to a word I say? Watch what I do? I showed you, you Mexican moron! Oh, try it. You haven't got the balls, or should I say the cojones. You're pathetic. See if you can finish the vacuuming without my having to show you how. Jesus.
Okay, 25.
I'm in. Yeah.
Well, I'll see you at 25 and raise your 5.
Count me in.
All right.
2 pair, beat it.
3 royal guys.
Oh, jeez.
Well, money comes to money.
No kidding.
Every time.
Ugh. Anyone read that report the other day? That of the addictive diseases, that drinking is far worse than smoking?
Oh,
how can that be? Everybody knows smoking is far more lethal than drinking.
Oh, yeah? Ever hear of a husband beating up his wife after too many cigarettes? Oh, that must be Deb.
How's he doing?
Great. He's thinking of becoming a teacher.
Oh, that's right. He's a history major.
Master's from Stanford.
Oh.
He'd be a natural, all the right qualities. You know, really, for now, you should encourage him.
Believe me, I'm after him all the time.
By the way, how old is he now?
28. Way too old for you, Jessica. Excuse me. Serve the drinks first when I ring the bell.
Someone has been in my
den. Not now, Deb, my guests, remember?
Some of my collection's missing!
So, Bud, how'd the operation go?
Well, I'm still here, but I'm not so sure about my sex life.
I said to Trent, anytime he can't rise to the occasion, then it's Viagra for him.
Listen. If Viagra's so great, how come Elizabeth Dole isn't the spokesperson?
Parnell?
Tell us, Deb, Viagra. It works. Say hello to everybody. Deb was unfortunate in puberty. It was a kidney problem, wasn't it, dear?
Parnell, we need to speak now.
Only one came down? Refused surgery, didn't you? Said nature will take its course. Well, it didn't. So now Deb's our resident eunuch. Well, Viagra notwithstanding, huh, sweetie? Consuelo drinks for my guests.
Why'd you do that?
Why'd I do what?
Humiliate Deb like that. You seem to take some kind of perverse pleasure in demolishing people. There must be something very much missing in your life.
Consuelo, when did you last change your stockings?
This morning.
There's a hole in them the size of a golf ball. Go change them immediately. Now.
Parnell, I've known you a long time. You are one cold-blooded control freak. And you're a cow. C-O-W, cow.
Takes one to know one.
I have another word for you.
Which we hope is goodbye. Go find yourself another boy toy, Jessica. Or is Botox your current bedmate?
At least I'd know what to do with a boy toy.
Well, like I always said, a visit to Parnell's is never boring.
Not
see what I mean? I'll get the drapes.
No, don't. It's too bright.
Not so much for 5-card draw.
There's always strip poker.
Oh? You have hidden assets?
She sure has. Could be therapeutic for you, eh, Bud?
Are you serious?
Are you?
I'll have Consuelo get the candles.
Ooh, kinky.
Consuelo? Consuelo! Consuelo!
Parnell, come on! She's scared. Parnell, your chicken!
That'll be the day.
Dev? Dev, where are we going? Dev! Where are we going?
Going?
We can't go back there.
Why not?
She's evil. She's a monster.
Consuela, half of that house is mine. Okay? Without it, I have nothing.
What about me?
What about you?
I have nowhere to go. No money, no papers, nothing. I'm illegal.
Consuela, half the state of California is illegal, all right? If the INS can't find two Middle Eastern terrorists in a flight school, you think they're gonna find you out of 32 million people? Okay. You don't have any money, you don't have any papers, so I'm stuck with you.
Deb!
Consuela, if there was a way to make Parnell leave, like, forever, would you help me? I mean, with her gone, I could come into some money. I could afford a decent immigration lawyer for you. I could get your papers once and for all. You want to live in the USA? Do you want to live in fear the rest of your life? Okay. Here's the thing. You understand?
And that's all?
That's it. And Parnell just moves on. Just like that train. Trust me.
Come on, Diana, it's your turn. Take it off. Let's see who's chicken.
Bud, give me two, Trent, my boy.
Open the door and said, let there be light.
What the hell?
Strip poker. You want to play?
Oh, Dev's handicapped.
Maybe he needs a little of my TLC. Testicle lowering catalyst.
Seeing is believing.
I think I'll let gravity do its job. Thanks. It's probably more than you should. And you. You are disgusting.
Party pooper. I was hoping to see a royal pair.
Shouldn't you be saving souls?
Saturday. I go in later.
Oh, thanks for reminding me. Joe's and Gavin's party is tonight. That is one not to be missed.
You gonna be here for dinner?
You're on your own. Iron the black mid-length cocktail dress. Oh, and I'll have my bath later around 6:30. Don't forget the heater.
Okay. I want you to run her bath in the usual way. Put this in the usual place, but do not plug it in. It's very important that you just, you don't plug it in. All right? And we'll meet where I said. Okay? You all set?
All set.
What's in there?
I need some things until she leaves.
She won't be leaving.
But you said...
Yeah, I did. She won't be leaving.
Why not?
The heater? There's a playwright. Swedish. His name's August Strindberg. He wrote a play called The Dance of Death. And that is exactly what the heater is going to do. It's gonna dance the dance of death. Plop. Right into the tub. Poached Parnell.
Not that way.
What other way is there?
Not that. Not that.
Have you forgotten so soon, Consuela?
No. We must go back.
You are crazy. Let go of the wheel.
No, it is at all.
Let go of the wheel.
No, no, no. No, it is at all. No, it is at all. But let
go.
Consuelo? Consuelo? Did you run my bath before the power went out?
Oh, still hot? Oh, she actually remembered. Well, almost.
Oh.
Wouldn't it be great if they never came back? Ever. Hallelujah.